Okay. So, let's go ahead. All right, here's our agenda for tonight. You can get rid of the first one because our treasurer is not in the building, so I'm sorry. We have money, don't worry about it. We're going to hear from Rita. Rita's still here. About the North High School intern program. Grace and her team is going to give us a truck shop update. Very exciting. Parks and Rec, are you here? Parks and Rec? They're going to give us just a general update. I like to have them come in once in a while. They have a lot of new programs all the time, so it's good to hear about that. Mary Ellen's here. Where is she? That's okay. To talk about 12th Street paving. So if you've seen the paving going on in the neighborhood, 12th Street is going to get paved. So there's some pretty specific and interesting things going on there. And then I just want to talk about volunteer opportunities. We're getting into the fall, and fall means everybody and their mother is outside. So we've got two big events coming up, Home Tour and Wing Fest. So I'll talk about those in detail a little bit later. So Rita, give you the floor.
Good evening, everyone. So my name is Rita Lopez, and I'm a teacher here at North High School, and I teach business. And so this year, we're starting an internship program, and on your tables, I actually have a little quick flyer. And so basically, I teach more of a business that interjects. The students get to learn a little bit about creating mobile apps. They're not experts, but they have an intro. They know how to create websites. They, of course, they know the basics of applications, Microsoft Word, PowerPoint, Excel. They do Canva.com. They are familiar with graphic designing. They create businesses. So they know the basics of what you working on the computer and working in business. They know how to apply for jobs. And so now we have our seniors that are looking at doing internship. And so this is our first year, like I said. And the flyer gives you a little bit of information. I don't want to take too much of your time. In the very bottom, I do have my email. I know that some of our community here are actually business owners. So these students would be basic entry level. So you may use them to maybe do the mail. They can be cashiers. They can make copies. They can do, basically at the end of the day kind of things that wrap you up. Don't hesitate to use them to maybe update your websites. They might need a little intro for your system that you're using initially, but they're pretty creative. So if this is something that maybe you may be interested in participating, hosting one of our students, or maybe you have a friend, we would really appreciate it. Okay? So please email me, and then we can go from there. So the students can come and interview. We'd like for them to go through the whole process. That makes it so easy for them. And then so they can just get a lot of good intro into our career paths. Okay? All right. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Rita. All right, Grace and team.
Okay, hi. Everyone, some people know me. I'm Grace Unger. I've been tech shop for 4 years, which is insane. It's flown by, and it's been really amazing to be part of the Coronado community. I'm actually a really bad speaker, so please don't laugh if my face turns red. I want to introduce today, this is Dorina Bustamante from True North Studio. I actually have been working alongside them and partnering with them for almost 3 years, yeah, quite a while. True North Studio is a real estate development company in the Roosevelt Rural Arts District. Really cool stuff. A ton of fun projects going on over there. And it just made a little bit more sense for me to partner with them with Tech Shop. So with that said, I'm gonna introduce you to Mr. Nett, who's amazing. But thank you for being here.
Thank you, Grace. But we all know how much she loves to talk. So if you have the pleasure of dining with her, she's the most gracious host. So I can click through it. Okay, cool. So I'm Dorina Bustamante, as Grace mentioned. I work with True North Studio. We are a real estate and community development company based in the Roosevelt Rural Arts District. Our office is in Saipan Market, if you're familiar with that landmark building on Roosevelt Row. We're here tonight to talk about some improvements that we're seeking some support on for Tuck Shop. Basically, some really simple things that we're doing with Grace to enhance the patio environment. Everyone knows that it's amazing outside, even in the summertime, and especially that restaurant. Grace always gets requests for people to sit outside and eat and drink. So we want to create that dynamic, and I'm here with our development manager, Justin Pasternak, who's actually going to talk through the technicalities. And we have our land use legal representation here, Mr. Nick Wood, to answer any technical questions. But we really just want to introduce you to the project that we want to explain to you tonight. So here we go. A little bit about what we do at True North Studio. We're massive supporters of the arts and culture, everything from film, fashion, music, culinary, photography, the art of ... We love doing historic preservation, adaptive reuse, and urban infill, everything from, you know, saving beautiful bungalows to, you know, filling in vacant lots. We love the highs next to the lows. We love alley activations, commissioning public art, all sorts of cool things. And we're excited to be working with Grace to help her expand the little patio dynamic over at Tuck Shop. And here we are, our favorite little gem in the Coronado neighborhood, and here you are, Justin.
Hi everyone, thank you for joining us. My name is Justin Pasternak, and I'll try to keep this nice and short for you guys. But I'm sure everyone's familiar with the Tuck Shop, right? Here's a couple of photos we took of the north portion. You can see kind of the existing entryway, the little patio just to the north, and kind of the current state of our most project. And what we're really trying to look to do is enhance this street corner. In our previous meetings, we learned that this really is kind of like the center of Coronado, right? This little turnaround. I'm really trying to activate that corner and breathe some life into it. We learned about all the great potential projects that may be happening on that corner. So if we can jump to the next one. This is kind of our preliminary plans of what we're looking to do, and really just bring the landscape back up to speed. Right now it's a prickly pear, I think, cactus arrangement that's a little bit sad, and we really want to breathe some life into this. We went to our landscape architects and asked for them to put together this palette that's really colorful and floral, but still above the natural desert palette. And as you can see, here's the existing Tuck Shop. There's existing a little patio, and we're just proposing to wrap the corner to really help engage that street corner, make it kind of a cafe kind of atmosphere. And I think it's about like 30 seats for you we might be adding to. So really, nothing earth-shattering, right? We just want to kind of enhance that patio, make it a little bit bigger, improve the landscaping is number one. And kind of a fun idea, what we talked about is being that you guys may be adding this bike route, adding more bike parking to this corner to really give a destination to this corner where you can park your bikes. I think there's like 6 spaces out there right now, but looking to really at least double that to give you the capacity to park your bikes. And that really, this could be a cool little corner, even though it is.
And the golf course.
And the golf course. And as you can see, it's pretty simple detailing. We want to do like a metal fence and have kind of this organic landscape, proposing vines. So it's really this buffer that's not this hard wall sitting on the corner, but it's kind of this soft buffer between the patio space and the street. And here you can see is the landscape palette. Very colorful. We wanted to bring in some color to this corner. And I think it's a great palette, you know, like not the typical prickly pear cacti that's out there right now, the sad cacti. But like I said, just breathing some life into this, architecture into this corner. And then we talked about like how, since we're increasing the landscape, we want to back up a couple slides. This is the roundabout in the corner. So we want to keep everything on that corner low level, so under 3 feet, so it's not impeding the views of people trying to make that turn. So we really could do anything from adding trees in that corner, but we did propose adding all of this low-level landscaping. So kind of a fun solution to what's out there right now.
Thank you, neighbor.
Yay! But I'd like to open up to any questions you guys might have.
Like back to the site plan, that helps the conversation.
Yeah.
Any questions? We'd love to hear your feedback. Really, our goal is to love on this little space.
sidewalk that runs along on that plant. Because my recollection is the sidewalk is here. As I walk to the east, the street is here. So when I look at that, I'm trying to understand where all those plants are going to be.
So this is, there's a little bump out right there, and that's the curb cut for the sidewalk. And basically, it's just that existing, I think it's a gabion wall, everything just outside of that. So exactly, if you go back to the photos.
Let's see, there's going.
So it's basically this corner of just bringing that.
So it's not encroaching on the right of way. It's where the landscaping already exists, but it's bringing it, flushing it up.
Yeah.
Yes, I go back to the site plan. I don't see the sidewalk.
So it's very, very light. This is the corner of it. We can beef up the graphics a little bit, but this is basically the edge of the sidewalk.
So you're going to bring the patio on the west side all the way to the sidewalk?
No.
We're going to leave a little bit of a buffer so we can get vines growing up this fence line. It's not even a fence. It's a 3-foot little barrier for the patio.
How big a buffer is a little bit of a buffer?
It's proposing about a foot.
So there's a 12-inch buffer and there's a 3-foot fence. You're going to push people right at the base of all the pedestrians and motorists.
There's a sidewalk on this corner too.
Right.
And there's also the landscape medium. There's a tree that's not shown on this plan right in that corner. And try to put some planting on that corner too.
So west side patio all the way
so
out.
So where are the existing on Fall Street? So those existing landscaping there, it's like rocky. So we would be staying right there because that's the property line.
Mm-hmm.
So it wouldn't go out,
it would go up beyond.
So like, obviously everyone knows. So this line here, that's where the patio would stay in that.
Yeah, it would stay on the rock side, but
yeah.
It would be right up against the sidewalk with the 1 foot with the steel fence with vines. They're supposed to grow on it on the western exposure against the concrete sidewalk on one side and a steel fence on the other. And it's going to be right up on the pedestrian right away.
It's sidewalk dining.
I've always just liked the way the tuck shop was tucked in and kind of insular and insulated. I like the fact that you're preserving the existing trees on the north side of the building. I just kind of feel like that patio all the way up to the sidewalk, the 1 foot buffer is no buffer.
Maybe we can squeeze maybe a little bit more out of it to give that.
I mean, just the umbrellas that are, I assume those orange things are umbrellas. Or planter wells, they look like they're intruding into the right of way. It just feels like it takes something that's just a great space that's perfectly tucked in and just shoves it right in your face. And I, it's your business, more power to you, but I don't know who'd want to sit on the western corner with cars looking by through a roundabout. I like the way it's situated right now. That's just my opinion. It's not my business, so.
And that's why we did add the umbrellas to give you some shade on that side.
Corner right now. Does anyone have more questions? I'd love to keep the conversation going.
other improvements, right? To basically, I don't know if you can talk about the workshop.
Talk about the workshop.
That's the sidewalk.
Yeah, but I think the concern is when you take that, this kind of piece.
Yeah.
If someone loses control and flips the, if I understand correctly, it's on that corner. I'm not structural engineer, but I'd be surprised if that will stop a car.
Yeah, I mean, it's, yeah, given the speed and proximity is,
there's still cars. I think your car is in
here. Yeah.
As the connected neighbor, I have never seen that happen, but I have seen over and over again people getting around about, so. In my 5-6 years of experience of being the only neighbor that's connected to the shop, I have not seen that happen.
You would just put an arrow on the fence point around.
That's here.
So,
I think what exists on there today is just the string lights right on the trees.
Yeah.
Is it required? I think it would, if you're trying to activate a corner, a sidewalk cafe type atmosphere would be better than having the fence up subdivided.
So we would, that would be the best case scenario, but unfortunately we're bound by, we have to create an enclosed space for the use permit of basically. So that's like the biggest thing, and that's why keeping it as minimal as possible and, you know, having the vegetation so ideally it disappears, right? That you don't perceive a wall.
So we're going to lose two or three mature mesquite trees from that west side?
We're going to try and work it into the plans, but we're looking at them, and the biggest area of concern with them is the proximity to the foundations of the building, that they're built, literally not built, but they're planted, you know, a foot off of the building, so they're probably encroaching the foundations. Not that it's an issue right now, but potentially as they grow and mature, that might maybe become an issue, so.
Website, whatever you need to do. So the first thing we have coming up for the little ones, we have an itty-bitty track meet coming up on September 7th over at Hans Park. It is a $5 entry fee. However, we're going to be doing sprints, long jumps, hurdles, shot put, javelin, just like a normal track meet. So we got that started. From there, we go to yoga at Hans Park as well, Saturday, September 14th. So anybody who's looking to do some yoga in the park, we've got that going. Hans will also have its Harvest Festival on September 15th. And we're kind of going farmer's market, lawn games, movie music, arts, crafts, good stuff there. So I got that going. Fall into parks over at, this will be Townsend, Roosevelt, Hans, from August through December. And again, just get out and get moving. By me over in Acano, we have tennis for the young ones, starting at age 5 and going up to 14. So we've started that. For those of you that enjoy pickleball, of course, we do have pickleball courts at Encanto. Okay? My daughter was never allowed to play pickleball or tennis because she played softball, and every time she hit the ball, it went over the fence. So our coach was like, you ain't playing tennis anymore. So we do have pickleball. Now, the biggest thing that we have coming up in Encanto Park is our concert in the park series. So on November 1st, which is Friday evening, at the Encanto Clubhouse patio, we are going to do jazz night. So we will have the Magic of Music featuring Doc Jones and his friends. We're bringing out a coffee house, baked sweets, a couple food trucks, and so we're going to be doing jazz under the stars. So it's not the greatest. I did it in black and white, but I didn't have a color printer, and it was getting a little close to time. So I have this one as well. I can email you these as well. I am looking forward to Wayne Fest. It'll be my first one. It'll be my first one, so I'm looking forward to it. I did do the Coronado's home tour last year. My particular endeavor at Encanto is the showmobile, which you guys have the stage come out for both Wayne Fest and Coronado home tour. That's my employees. That's my biggest thing to work with, amongst other things. So I will be out there. I'm looking forward to it. So, but every time you see the stage, you'll see me popping in and out. So you keep an eye on staff and make sure they do your job and keeping everything right. So I will turn these over to you. Okay. Any questions on what we've got going? Hi, ma'am.
How do we get some of those things to Coronado? I mean, I know we can't do all this and that, but
it's a matter of finding people who want to teach. That's the biggest thing. The instructor that I have in Channel Park, he's on what we call a qualified vendors list. So we have to register with the city and jump through lots of hoops to become an instructor. I do know that we do have some park activation over there in the way of field reservations. I do know that the kids do come out and play. We do have special operations, which does come out and do soccer and t-ball and some of that. And so the hardest part with Coronado and Monterey is parking, because the parking is so small a lot. So, but if we can find people to help coach, then we can do that. And that's something we can definitely
do. We have soccer, we do have soccer, and a lot of other things, but I'm saying about jazz night. Let me just give you a point. Drinking and music, we really
know. You know who to get a hold of, and who knows how to get a hold of Broadway. So that is possible.
But if it's jazz night, to pet for the ballets in the park, whatever, because we're not really has a mixture of a lot. And I hear the E word, but I don't really want to hear the E word.
It's just a matter of organizing it and pulling what you want to do. We can do a movie in the park. The biggest thing with a movie in the park is finding the actual screen to put it on. That's the hardest. Sometimes we do it on the walls of the bathroom. We've done that out in the park. So it's just a matter of what you guys want to organize, what you want to do. So any other questions I can help you with? No? Okay. Thank you again for inviting me. I appreciate it.
Marielle, you are up. Marielle is gracious enough to join us last minute, like it was like 11th hour.
Yes, it's her last minute. Okay, I'm sorry I don't have slides. Transportation Program Manager at the City of Phoenix. I know you're going to ask, so I can bike in the skirt, but I didn't bike tonight because I hurt my hand. So I can't actually brake right now. So I had to drive. So today I'm here to talk about the 12th Street proposed buffered bike lane. So right now, just outside, I'm turning around in the building, but east on 12th Street, just outside of the building, there are existing bike lanes. So the street is going to be repaved. Right now the travel lanes are pretty wide, and so the city is looking at the possibility of putting in buffers on the bike lane, so it will narrow the travel lanes a little bit, kind of, you know, encourage people to go the speed limit, and it'll give a little bit of buffer for the bike lanes. It won't change the way traffic works in the traffic circle. We're not going to change anywhere where there's an existing right turn lane or left turn lane. There's not a bike lane, it doesn't change that. It's just existing bike lanes give a little buffer. There's also the possibility of maybe putting in vertical separation, so the little bollards that pop up just outside of the school where there's no parking. The idea behind that is it might stop people from parking in the bike lane when they're not supposed to. but that is a very much like, that's just a proposal. I want to hear what you guys, what your thoughts are on it. And then we also have to make sure that our maintenance staff is comfortable with it too, because it raises a lot of maintenance issues. So it's just kind of floating out there right now. Other than that, that's it. It's really open to questions. And I saw that.
Hi, I'm the neighbor on 12th Street, so I was during work on the last traffic aid that was up. I was getting around because someone did not see how they were blocked from their stop sign. And the people that were in charge, I think it's traffic aid, that's actually through the barricades, where what we ended up seeing on the corner of Elmira and 12th Street is that barricades were all messy. You know, they didn't have that maintenance throughout the whole day. That is why someone ran the stop sign.
Infrastructure that's underneath the 2 inches that they keep milling off, and
the timeline for the pavement project is soon. I think it's in the middle of the month. So it's already set to repave. There's nothing that's going to change that. And it's you will be getting notification. It's one of those things where it's like, okay, we have a cruise out. What's going to get paved? So it's like right now scheduled for September 17th.
And what's the distance?
It would be Thomas to McDowell.
How long the construction?
It's a few days usually. Yes.
I just want to express thank you for making Fall Street a priority. I don't drive down it anymore because it's been so bumpy, so I really appreciate that that's going to get better. And then I also want to say thank you for thinking about protected bike lanes. That is super exciting to hear. You're probably aware of the discussions that have been happening regarding Oak Street. The neighborhood is very excited about having some increased bike infrastructure there, and we're very open to creative ideas about reducing travel lane width, with the understanding that that's a great way to reduce travel speeds in the neighborhood. 12th Street is one of the main streets in the neighborhood that people get upset about people going too fast. And so the idea of reducing travel lanes and having more for bikes, that's awesome. And I want to commend you on making that a priority.
Thank you. Oh, I do want to say one thing about the barricades. It's not, just so you kind of understand and visualize a little bit, if it were to happen, it would be like those little flexible bollards that are about 3 inches high, 3 inches, 3 feet, and it would just be right along where the bike lane is, and probably only be for a block, so it's not, it won't be major, it won't block visibility, just so you can kind of understand what that looks like. Yes.
I just want to clarify, you said that the buffered bike lanes are proposed, however, you said that this upcoming month, through the middle of the month, is going to be the beginning of the construction project. So at what point can we express support and also see a detailed plan so that we can, I guess, have more information and also give us an opportunity to show our support?
If you have support or not support for the plan, you should probably be contacting your official or my office as soon as possible. You can do it from the minute you hear about the project and have something to say. The detailed plan, the notification will be coming out hopefully in the next few days. We're still trying to make sure that we know the width of the proposed buffer so that we are giving you guys accurate information when we send it out. It will be sent out digitally and you will share it with everyone. Okay, so if you're here, if you're on the mailing list, you'll get that email. Yes?
This is probably a little thing, but you're probably going to repaint the crosswalk blocks around the various places on 12th Street. We've talked about the 12th Street is, people don't go to paint most of them. And I've seen things where you could make the crosswalks look like almost like optical illusions. I've seen, Melrose does cool things with the crosswalks where they have the rainbow things in it. Is that an option to kind of repaint it, do something cool with it?
That is a great idea. I don't think it's an option with this one. The idea with the paving projects is our striping crews will paint everything back the way it is. And then we're looking for those opportunities to see if there's an opportunity to change things a little bit. Doing those optical illusion crosswalks, I don't know if they've happened in the city of Phoenix before.
And in their test market. Yeah, we had this great test shop on the corner. I don't know where certain people are going to go and bring it all in. It's a public
illusion. I think we're very open to the idea of doing demonstration projects and kind of looking at what's possible. I think with the timeline on this, because it's so fast and because it's pretty set, other than like, is there a buffer or not, I don't think this would be a project where you get that to happen. But you should have my contact information and I want to talk to you about this because I think it is important to start looking at options like that.
This would be a good neighborhood to try it out. It's enjoy it.
And just to warn you, typically when those things happen in other cities, it's usually not the city that pays for it, it's a neighborhood.
But Phoenix is different.
I think the Melrose, their Merchants Association got together and they hired an artist to do those. Grand Avenue does that. Grand Avenue Merchants Association done green landscape with those kinds of spots and tiles on it. So a lot of the artists.
questions, comments?
Yes. So there is opportunity to make sure that you know we're coordinating with TechShop just if there is any coordination that has to happen. The 12th Street, it's going to happen, that it's going to be repaved, and it's just mostly a CT project, so I don't know how to, where the, if there would be much access between those two projects.
This project is moving very quickly. Paving's going to happen. I got a call from Joe, one of her co-workers, about the possibility of putting buffered bike lanes, and I thought, given the temperature of the neighborhood, this would be a good opportunity to put that in there, slow down traffic, protect bikers. I'm excited to hear about the north thing. I get calls about that every week. So maybe do that, dissuade people from parking there is great. Okay, so a couple of opportunities to get involved. I got involved in home tour 7-9 years ago, something like that. And here I am. So it was a great opportunity to meet people, very low stress, very casual. You do as much or as little as you want to do. But this is our biggest fundraiser for the year. I think we had 180 volunteers last year, which was the most. 182, which was the most ever. So more hands, like work, all that stuff. So if you want to get involved, an email our home tour at coordinatorway.com. They are looking for more help. I give you some idea of what they're looking for, but just because it's not out there doesn't mean they don't need it. So if you have a particular interest, reach out to them. If you want to hang out in the petting zoo. But if you want to do that, that's fine. You can do that. So just reach out and say I'm available on this day for as much time. Wayne Fest 2.0 is coming. We need everything, much like a home tour, although on a much smaller scale. It takes a lot of people to pull this thing off. So if you're interested in volunteering at Wayne Fest, obviously free admission, all that stuff. You can send a note to waynefest@coordinatorway.com. I suppose I can tell you. It's November 16th. Thank you. So November 16th is Wayne Fest, barring any problems with the city telling us we can't, which I don't think will happen. But so that's all I got. Any questions about Wayne Fest or home tour? All right. Yes, Amy. Roughly $32,000, something like that.
That's awesome. And that's thanks to all these volunteers, which is really
cool. Absolutely. Yeah, we can't do the things we want to do without that. Someone asked me the other day, what's our focus this year? Last year was the garden, I think. Our long-term plan is to get a proper community center. Because right now, if you know, we're garden and tool shed, and we're at that house. Our lease ends on that house in 2 years, basically. After that, we don't have a place to go. So the board's working hard to find a spot that we can put a flag in and own it forever. So that's what we're shooting for this year. Okay, any other questions? Any other questions? All right, thanks everybody for coming. Next month here, October 3rd. Thanks so much for coming. Appreciate it.